Hello and welcome back to another video. I know a lot of you guys are here probably from searching up CLX and wanting to know more about them as a company. So in today's video, I'm going to be taking an in-depth look at the PC that they sent me over a couple of weeks ago, and we're going to be taking a look at their site as a whole to give you guys a better idea about the whole company and how good their products are. Now, this is probably the hardest video I've ever worked on, and it would be amazing if you guys could hit that thumbs up button for me. As well, if you guys want to see more content, hitting that subscribe button will also keep you up to date on all of the content that I am posting. And lastly, I'll be completely transparent with you guys, CLX did give me a referral link for the site. This is gonna be the last time I'm gonna mention this for the entire video, but I want to assure you guys that I'm gonna be as unbiased as possible. I'm not gonna promote this link, as nice as it would be to sell a bunch of PCs for them. I'm not a sales rep and I don't intend to be one. It's a perk and a nice consideration. If you want to know more about what's going on with that, there will be a summary in the description. All right, now that I'm done with that, let's get into the video. So I thought the best way to start off this video is with my thoughts on the system that they sent me. The system that they sent me is called a CLX RAW. Now there isn't one version of this PC, and we'll get into that when we get over to the site part of this video, but the version that they sent me was a very high-end system. In terms of specs, it has a Ryzen 9 5950X, a RTX 3090, 32GB of G-Skill Trident Z memory, a 500GB PCIe Gen 4 NVMe SSD, a 3TB hard drive, an ASUS X570 ROG Strix motherboard, a 1000W EVGA 80+ gold PSU, and a 360mm AIO liquid cooler. The machine performs great and chews through any video editing tasks that I have. It runs cool for the parts that are in the system. Mind you, these are some of the highest end processors that you can buy on the market, and their power consumption is absolutely crazy. An artificial load maxing out the GPU and the CPU, the temps get to be around 80 degrees C on the CPU, and the GPU sits around 76 degrees. Now, I know you guys might think that for liquid cooling on the CPU, the temps seem a bit high, but I kind of expected this since the way the AIO fans are set up, they are exhausting a lot of the hot air the GPU is shooting up. The card in the system is a PNY card with a pass-through design, so all of the hot air moving out of the GPU is passing through the rad at the top, which is causing the increase in temps, but when it's just the CPU that is being stressed, the temps get to be around 70 degrees C on a silent fan profile. Now, in terms of packaging, if you buy a CLX RAW, you get this really cool crate that it's shipped in. And if you want to see a short unboxing of the PC, you can click on this card up above. It was packaged extremely well and basically had no chance of being damaged during shipping. As well, all the things that a person might need for upgrades or troubleshooting are in two boxes that came with the PC. One had all of the part documentation, extra PSU cords, and a cool t-shirt that they sent me, which I'm wearing while I am recording this footage, and the other had extra hard drive bays and stuff for the PC case. Now, I'm not sure if this was intentional or not, but they did not include the Wi-Fi antenna for the motherboard. Luckily, my current PC's Wi-Fi antenna was compatible with the one on this PC's motherboard, but if I was a guy who bought this PC and I was expecting to use it solely on Wi-Fi, I'd be fairly upset. Now, I know from reading reviews that they would send you an antenna immediately, but it still would suck to have to wait for a part that should have been included with the PC in the first place. In terms of cable management on this PC, it's great. There are no loose dangling cords and everything just looks clean. Now, there was one issue in terms of cables, and I think it might have just been an issue with the foam insert or just not pushing it down all the way, but I wasn't getting any signal from the front USB-C connector, and after reseating it on the motherboard, it seems to work fine. Again, my have just wiggled loose during shipping or moving the PC, but still would be annoying to the normal customer. Now, if we take a look at the back side panel cable management, I think it looks fine. The case does have kind of these little cover-up hidey hole things to kind of make sure everything does look clean, even if they don't do the best job. When you do take a look at it, you can tell that they did put a lot of effort into tidying things up. Though it may look a bit messy, I think it's just because of the extra PSU cables in the system, as well there's a lot of fan connectors as well. If you get a fully modular PSU, I'm sure it'd be a lot cleaner, but since this is a semi-modular one, there's really only so much that you can do to make things look nice and neat. Now, the case itself is super nice. It has great airflow, easy user access, a dope custom paint job, and a front magnetic dust filter to make sure everything inside your system stays nice and clean. There are no faults with the case. I looked over the entire thing and couldn't find any dents or scratches. The paint has a hard glossy finish that seems durable and really isn't likely to get chipped or scratched. And overall, my experience with the PC over these past couple of weeks has been great. There is no pre-installed bloatware, which is a major plus, and all of the drivers were up to date, and Windows was also up to date at the most current version. Again, my only large critique would be if you are planning on buying a higher-end system from them, make sure to get higher quality fans just to improve overall case temperatures and to make sure that everything's nice and quiet. All right, now let's move on to the CLX site. When you hop onto the CLX site, you will notice the Egyptian theme and that you can either choose from a list of pre-configured gaming PCs or you can customize your own. If you're looking to build your own, you have four options. You can go with the CLX Set, the CLX Scarab, CLX Aorus, and the CLX Raw. Each of these has its own price points that they fulfill. The Scarab is their ITX form factor build. The Set is more of a low to mid end PC. The Aorus is more of a mid to high end, and the Raw is high end all the way. Just by looking at these PCs, you can tell there's more customization than most gaming PC companies. They have about everything you might need when it comes to building your own PC. And when I say about everything, I mean everything. You can choose the case fans, if you want any RGB strips, and if you choose any PC other than the Set, you can get a custom paint job. For core components, you can choose your CPU, whether that be Intel or AMD. You can choose your memory and its speeds. You can choose your GPU, all the way from a RX 560 all the way up to dual RTX 3090s. You can choose your power supply along with any braided cables, what kind of drive you want for a boot drive, and what you might want for a secondary drive. You can choose hard drive accelerators, sound cards, network cards, and capture cards. You can choose what kind of cooling you want, whether that be air cooling, a all-in-one liquid cooler from a 120mm to a 360mm radiator, a custom softline or hardline loop for your CPU, GPU, or both, what kind of thermal paste you want to use, and if you want them to factory overclock your CPU or your GPU. Now, I know that was super fast, but if any of that caught your attention, I would go to their site linked down below and just take a look around. But I think you guys kind of get the point. If you want to choose what you want on your PC, they will most likely have it, and pricing is good too. A PC from CLX with a Ryzen 7 3700X and a RTX 3070 compared to a VRLA Tech PC with the same specs is only about $200 cheaper, and the CLX machine has a better case, PSU, motherboard, and it has a 120mm cooler compared to an air cooler on the VRLA Tech PC. Now, VRLA Tech is one of those companies that goes straight for value, and I recommend them to most people who are just looking to get the best bang for their buck. But CLX really isn't too far off from them in terms of value. If you take a look at a company like Digital Storms, a $1,600 gaming PC has a air-cooled Ryzen 5 3600 with a GTX 1650. And people will point out to Digital Storms, lifetime warranty and tech support. Well, sorry to break it to you, but CLX has something very, very similar. Another really nice thing about CLX is they seem to always have the newest parts as an option. I mean, the AMD RX 6000 series launched only a day before I started writing this section, and CLX has it as an option on their website. So if you're looking for a pre-built with the latest hardware, CLX has got it for you. Now, there are a lot of positives for these guys, but I just wanted to use this later part of the video for some constructive criticism. The pre-configured systems that they have on their site need updating. They don't look very appetizing to many people, especially when you have Ryzen systems with memory speeds at 2666. I think that if you're going to even have a Ryzen system available on that pre-configured list, the minimum memory speed should be 3200 MHz. Anything below that is going to really negatively affect the CPU's performance. As well, I think that having multiple generations of CPUs within the same tab is a nightmare for people who don't know a whole lot about PCs. I think that for CPUs, maybe you can include a Cinebench single core and multi-core score for each CPU, and include maybe somewhere that the single core score kind of indicates the performance in games, and multi-core kind of indicates the performance in things like video editing and streaming, just so people can get a rough estimate of how it will perform against other CPUs on the site in the tasks that they want to use it for. As well, I think a short little summary of each component and how it performs against other options and various things would help inform less knowledgeable buyers and help them make their decision. There are, of course, a bunch of other changes that they can make to their site to make it a bit more friendly for people who are looking to make a purchase, but overall, I think that their site is great. It gives you a ton of options and it lets you make the choice of what you want to spend your money on. As well, if you need any help, they have a little chat box in the bottom right corner of your screen which connects you with one of their support agents. Basically, if you have any particular questions about a certain configuration or a certain part, they should be able to answer you fairly quickly. So in summary, I really like these guys and what they do. I think that they offer solid products with customization and for a great price. They aren't the best go-getters for just straight value, but they beat out a lot of other gaming PC companies in their category. CLX mostly caters toward mid to high-end PCs, even though they do have some lower-end ones that they sell. If it were me though, I would honestly save a couple extra $100 and just buy a better one, or just go somewhere else like Skytech or VRLA Tech to get a good cheap value gaming PC. And in terms of the problems with my PC, I think that with all companies there's going to be a bad batch here and there, and honestly I'm kind of glad that I got them, because if this was the worst there was out there, then most of their PCs should be virtually flawless. I'm a big fan of their lifetime support on their PCs, and from their reviews I have read, their customer support is great as well. It's been great talking to you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Again, it took me a while to put this thing together, so leaving a like if you guys did enjoy the video means a lot to me. And if you want to see more content like this, feel free to hit that subscribe button as well. If you have some questions about these guys or have questions about PCs in general, or just want to talk to fellow gamers and hardware enthusiasts, come over and join the Hardware Junkie Discord server linked down below. So thanks again for watching, and I hope I will see you guys in the next one.